time visiting London, here are 10 important things you need to know before taking public transport. If you know them, you'll be golden. By the way, if you're new here, I'm Jess and I make videos for people who are coming to visit London, and I have a special freebie for you at the end of the video, so keep watching. No public transportation in London takes cash, so here are a few ways that you can pay for your rides. First up is an Oyster card. Get one of these, top it up, re-top it up when you need to, and that's it. You can also use your debit or credit card if it has the contactless feature enabled on it, or if you have a card from outside the UK, sometimes the contactless feature and mobile pay doesn't work. So I usually recommend for people to just get an Oyster card. It's the easiest way and the most reliable. You need to tap in and tap out. When you're taking a train or the underground in London, you always have to make sure you tap in at the first station you get on at and tap out at the station that you leave at. This is because you get charged depending on how much distance that you travel. Most of the time, you're gonna hit barriers to get into the station and out, so you'll know that you need to tap in and tap out, but sometimes at night they leave the barriers open, so make sure you still tap in and tap out even if that happens. Rush hour is major in London, so try not to travel on public transport at those times if you can. You will avoid major crowds and major traffic. Try to walk if you can. If you need to avoid steps when getting around London, the buses are always going to be your best bet because they're equipped with ramps and wheelchair accessible seating. You'll also see on every tube map that the accessible stations are marked off. If you have other accessibility needs, I've left some links down in the description of this video to other resources that will help you out. London's transportation system has a daily cap, which means if you travel a lot around each day, you will only be charged a certain amount. How much you get charged depends on how many zones that you've traveled through. And if you don't know what zones are, you should watch the video that's popping up here in the corner that will tell you all about how zones work. If you're using an Oyster card and you need to check how much balance you have, there are two ways to do it. The first is to use one of the ticket machines in a station, or when you tap out at a barrier, you'll see the amount of credit that's left on your card flash up. Here's how to stop a London bus. If you're waiting at the bus stop and you see your bus coming, put your hand out and it will tell the driver to stop. If you're already on the bus and you need to get off at the next stop, press the red stop button and it will tell the driver that you want to get off. The tube runs until midnight from Sunday to Thursday, but select lines and tube stations are part of the night tube, which means they're open all night, Friday and Saturday. To figure out which stations and which lines are part of the night tube, you can open up the night tube map. Also, City Mapper and Google Maps are smart enough and they know which ones are open when you're trying to get home. Finally, you'll get the hang of it. Honestly, if you know these tips, you'll be totally fine. And after a couple rides in the system, you will be a pro. Plus, us Londoners mess it up all the time, so don't worry. If it's your first time visiting London, you should get my free London 101 guide. It tells you everything you need to know before you get here. Click the link in the description to get that. And for more tips and tricks for London, click one of the videos that's popping up over here. Okay.
Ooh, bird.
Pay for your rides. Ooh.
Wait there.
Did you get that?